Dana in New South Wales, Australia. There must be an old South Wales. And of course there is. Wales, that's in the UK. All right. Hi, Paul. Hello from Port Macquarie in New South Wales, Australia. Well, hello from Boulder. I have heard, although my 51-year-old brain can't remember where, that a subwoofer will adopt the damping factor of the amplifier that it gets its signal from. Is that true? Boy, that's a stretch, man. So here's the deal. If we connect a subwoofer up the way that I like to do it, the way that my friend John Hunter from REL likes to do it, using the output of your power amplifier into the high-level input of your subwoofer, that's the right way to connect it, as opposed to the way most people connect it, which is using an RCA cable or an XLR cable, which is low-level coming from your preamp or your surround processor. That's the wrong way to do it. And the reason that we like to have the output of the power amplifier feeding our subwoofer is because, to some extent, the sound of what's driving your main speakers, and all amplifiers have a sound to them, is carried forward for a more seamless presentation by your subwoofer. So in that respect, yes, your sub will carry forward the sonic characteristics of your power amplifier. Those sonic characteristics include a damping factor, but that doesn't affect the sound of the amplifier. So I know that's complicated. Let me explain. The damping factor of a power amplifier, which means how well can the power amplifier control the loudspeaker. Damping factor is the lower the output impedance, the more grunt and power that that amplifier has to exert over its connected main speaker, that's the higher the damping factor, the more control and lower impedance, right? Higher impedance amp have a fairly low damping factor. So how well does it damp it? How well does this amplifier control the speaker, as opposed to the back EMF and whatnot from the speaker controlling the amplifier, okay? So if you had a relatively low damping factor, you could suggest that as a certain kind of a loudspeaker might affect the sound of that, yes, that would be passed through to the subwoofer. In general, in a modern amplifier that has a reasonable damping factor, you're not going to hear any difference. It won't make any difference. It's only the difference that you'd hear in the main speaker, if that makes sense. So, all right, sorry for a complicated sort of thing, but that's basically it. So in general, with a modern amplifier, no. Okay?